So Anooshka, the Society of Antiquaries, has got in its collection some of Edward IV's hair. So where did it come from?
Well, the lovely thing about the Society is that we can link objects from our museum collection to documents in our library collection. One of the best sources that we have is the meticulous notes that were taken, the minutes taken during Society meetings. We know that Edward's tomb was opened on Friday the 13th in 1789, and the superintendent of works, who was Henry Evelyn, took really detailed drawings of what he saw. It's also highly likely that the Dean of Windsor was present, and he was a fellow of the Society of Antiquaries. Okay. And on the 4th of March 1790, he communicated to the Society further information about the discovery. So if we go to the section of the minutes that relate this, we can see that a letter was read from the Lord Bishop of Carlisle, who was also the Dean of Windsor, to the President as follows. And he outlines Mr. Evelyn's discovery. What he also notes is, "Your Lordship will also receive a paper in which you will find some of King Edward's hair and a few small bits of the Queen's wooden coffin."
Excellent.
So we know that the hair was sent to the Society direct from the Bishop of Carlisle, who was also the Dean of Windsor. He was likely to have been present when Edward's tomb was opened.
That's excellent.
And the nice thing as well is that the Bishop of Carlisle, who's communicating this to the President, was also a fellow of the Society. So he would have understood the importance and the significance of ensuring that material culture, so physical objects, had a context and a backstory. And this is what he's providing here. He's providing the detailed accounts by Evelyn of the discovery.
Yeah.
So that's the really important link.
And these drawings are beautiful. They are so detailed.
These were the drawings made by Henry Evelyn, which were then submitted to the Society and reproduced in Vetusta Monumenta, which was a major publication of the Society's. This is volume 3. And as you can see, he's made views both of the lead coffin in the tomb, the graffiti that was found over the archway within the tomb, and you can also see the coffin open and Edward's skeleton inside. And there is an inordinate amount of hair in
there. But this is really, really important, because the provenance, knowing that this is actually Edward IV's hair, is really, really important. So this is all just really fantastic.